Hey guys, it's me, Tony Wilson, except now I'm shorter and fatter and a completely different person named Tristan Cooper. Hi. Nintendo sent us a copy of Splatoon 2 for the Nintendo Switch, so I have obviously been playing it a lot. I decided I would do something new. I'm going to assess its qualities, and I'm going to give you a rundown of a feature. I'm going to review a video game. I'm going to be honest with you here. I never played the first Splatoon, mostly because I didn't have a Wii U. I know, it's me, the one guy who didn't have a Wii U. But like the Switch was a refinement of the concepts of the Wii U, Splatoon 2 has taken a good game and made another good game. Like Splatoon 1, the sequel was based entirely around rolling, exploding, and otherwise shooting fluids all over the place like a set dresser on CSI. You fire the ink to cover territory, you swim in the ink to move up walls and across the battlefield, and then you fire ink again to blast enemies. That core loop of fire, swim, fire is pretty simple, but it feels good every time. Even though it's technically a shooter, Splatoon 2 doesn't really play like anything else in the genre. It's sort of like how Nintendo took fighting games in a different direction with Super Smash Bros., which almost has more in common with sumo wrestling than it does with a street brawl. And Nintendo gets the most mileage out of the ink in this single player mode, where this lady named Marie sends you on short missions to find a giant fish along with her missing sister Callie. Wait, Callie? Marie? Calamari. Oh, do you think they know they did that? You might be quick to dismiss these levels as a training mode for multiplayer, but that would be ignoring all the creativity and variety in these little bite-sized levels. They're kind of like Mario Galaxy almost. Whenever this little minion guy thing gives you a new weapon, the game teaches you how to use it in a way that doesn't feel like homework. Like when you get the charge rifle, the game eases you into the sniper timing and distance when you shoot at these little mini teleporters. It's way more fun than being at a shooting range or target practice. Some of the levels have you chasing these little bastards around the map, which encourage you to go through that fire, swim, fire loop a little bit faster. These are definitely skills you can take back into multiplayer. And then some levels are just Sonic Heroes. Even the bosses have their own lessons to give you. This samurai guy here keeps reminding you that area control is vital, and that you should always make sure to have an exit strategy. Then there's this boss, who teaches you how to quickly climb a giant oven with angry bread loaves sticking out of it. Not everything always applies. The diversity of the campaign sort of makes me wish they'd implement some of the wilder stuff in multiplayer, which is really the meat of the game. There are a couple of interactable imports in the single player, like this expandable sponge here, but for the most part, the arenas are static and inflexible. I know that they probably didn't want to piss off the esports community when they had a good thing going, but it does feel like they're playing it safe in one of the freshest franchises around. Ranked playlists do mix it up with King of the Hill style matches, but these focus modes are more competitive than freewheeling. Sometimes I just want to play Smash Bros. With items on. Come on. There is a new feature in the game Nintendo won't tell you about, the Nemesis system. It's sort of like the one in Shadow of Mordor, except instead of an orc with a grudge, it's just this guy named Laser Brain who won't stop killing me when I'm trying to make a video. I almost forgot about the big third pillar of this game, Salmon Run. It's a wave-based co-op survival mode that pits a team of four against tons of bad guys and several bosses that aren't seen anywhere else in the game. It's horde mode, but it's Nintendo's horde mode, which is simultaneously ridiculous and also just as engaging as the rest of the game. Gets pretty tough in the thicker waves, too. Splatoon 2 is one of those games you can play casually on your couch with a podcast running in the background, or you can go full tryhard and try to play competitively. The game is completely suited to either playstyle because its simplicity feeds its versatility. Everything in this game is so easy to grasp that you don't even need voice chat. You have these three call-out buttons, this way, help, and booyah, and that's really all you need. You don't need anything else to communicate with your teammates. I know I personally could use a Laser Brain is harassing me online button, but that probably wouldn't fit in the corner. I should say that there is a special app coming out soon that will allow voice chat for your phone, but it wasn't released at the time of this recording. I honestly can't tell you if you should just use Discord instead, but seriously, just use Discord. But that's the thing. Like the previous game, Splatoon 2 is slated to get all sorts of free updates all over the next year, so it's not like this review won't be completely obsolete in a month anyway. It's almost like in an age of constant patches and developers treating their products like ongoing services, reviews are becoming more and more outmoded, and I sort of question why I did this. Coming back to Salmon Run, I did want to address the weird, limited time window that this mode has, since you can only play it online during certain dates and times. On one hand, I understand that running it like a limited time playlist gives you a better chance of matching up with teammates when you do log on because everyone else will be on at the same time. It sort of makes it like a little mini event, like a smaller version of the Splatfest, which were always fun. But when the salmon run isn't active, you can't even play a quick online game with people on your friends list. Your only option is to get a bunch of people together in person for local play, which sucks because cool 20-something Switch-haver Karen only has those rooftop parties like once a month, tops. It still boggles my mind how Nintendo is so unbelievably good at game design and so strict and backwards when it comes to anything involving the internet. At least this game is a looker. I don't know if you have seen the video that has been playing the last several minutes. Everything is so bright and round, and it feels like a plush Nicktoon from the early 2000s. I love the swagger of my character when I win a match. I love how much personality the new hosts have. I love the way ink falls on the battlefield when Laser Brain destroys me again. Even the transition when you switch stores is beautiful. Look at that. More games should be this wobbly and jiggly, and no, I did not mean it like that. There's something about spraying ink everywhere in Splatoon 2 that's so immediately satisfying, in concept and in quality. It's sort of like the opposite of Super Mario Sunshine, a game where you spend your time washing the personality out of everything, returning it to its pristine, lifeless state. But with Splatoon 2, you get to claim whatever you see with your own personal color, your own brand, instantly interacting with the level and visibly changing the world state without killing anything. And then you also get to kill things. I guess this is sort of why people are so into Minecraft. Laser Brain, you unthinkable prick! I do have some other problems with the game, like how I couldn't get the sensitivity just right in handheld mode, or that the jumping sometimes kind of feels too floaty, but these aren't problems that are gonna stop me from playing the game after release. If nothing else, I have to see what the fake Miiverse is up to. You know what? On second thought, maybe not. Now, I don't really like the idea of review scores, but I do respect that these kinds of numbers help calculate whether something like Splatoon 2 is going to be worth it for you if you have a limited gaming budget. So I've come up with a rating system compromise that will make sure nobody is happy. All right, you ready? I give Splatoon 2 a 6.16 out of 7. Laser Brain, you shit! You piece of shit!